Hello, my name is Nicola Wilck. I'm from Berlin, Germany, and next to me are Professor Bina Joe and Ms. Blair Mell from the University of Toledo, Ohio. They will be presenting on the role of the gut microbiome in hypertension tomorrow. And this is an exciting field of research. So the gut microbiome and cardiovascular disease, how do these two worlds go together?
Yeah, that's a nice question. In fact, a well-timed question. If you look at all the research that has gone on in the genomics world, we have been restricted to the whole genome of the host. And we haven't really looked at another complete genome that resides within us, which is the microbiome. And these are exciting times to look forward to a lot of research in the area of the gut microbiome and how it influences hypertension in particular, which is the question we are asking in the lab. And I'm sure in the next few years to come, this is going to just build up heavily. There are only very few labs working on it now, and all of the labs that are involved, most of the labs that are involved, are going to be at this meeting, which is exciting. The current concept is that we really know for sure that the microbiome influences hypertension. That is what we have learned and we're going to be talking about tomorrow. But what goes from that point is the mechanisms of it. How is it doing it? How is it influencing the host genome? Are they crosstalking? Are they independent? And when it comes to in the context of salt, for example, how do environmental factors play a role in this process? Blair has discovered that what we find in our animals is a salt-sensitive phenomenon, which she's going to talk about. You want to talk about it a little bit today?
Yes. So our study uses the doll rat model, which the S and R rat, the S rat being salt-sensitive and the R rat being salt-resistant. And we see many genetic variants between these two. Even though they were both generated from the Sprague Dolly rat, there are many genetic variants, and also their gut microbiota is very different between the two.
So the diseased microbiome is different. So what is your opinion? Is the host shaping the microbiome, or is it other environmental factors?
The predominant factor we are after is the host genome, because the same genome, the S rat, which is a salt-sensitive hypertensive animal, it behaves differently when it's given microbiota from the salt-resistant animal. So when we put that in, blood pressure goes up, which is very intriguing for why would it go up? And the composition of the microbiota is something very, very important to look at. Technologically, we might be limited at this point to have a view into all the specific species of bacteria that are in there that are causing all of the effects that we observe. So in years to come, I would anticipate the research to be taken away from just the firmicutes or the bacteroidetes or certain classes into very unique type of bacteria that are causing these phenotypes that we observe. If you look at it for a therapeutic interest for where we would go into humans with this, the field is exciting for where it could go. It would be simple interventions at the dietary level with yogurt, with certain strains of bacteria that may help with preventing the progression of hypertension or even decreasing the susceptibility over the genetic susceptibility they have. So those are some ideas which are really in its infancy at this time, but eventually I see this coming on as a big theme. As you saw today, the director of the NHLBI making an impact of this point in his presentation, that the microbiome, in addition to epigenetics, could play a major role in contributing to the genesis of hypertension.
So hypertension specialists should care about the microbiome in antihypertensive therapy, is that your point?
Absolutely. But for them to care deeply about it, we need more research to be done very carefully. We are at the front engine part of this with tools and techniques available at our disposal to study this. The gut neural connections are being investigated. The intestinal loads are being investigated. Some of these are being presented tomorrow. And I think the dynamics of this, the scope of this is just beginning to unfold.
Yes.
And clinicians will eventually have access to actual mechanistic knowledge of how this operates and be careful in using it in their practice. And that's way down the lane, if I can say so. I know you're presenting some work tomorrow. Could you enlighten us a little bit on what you're going to talk about?
I'm going to talk about the role of short-chain fatty acids in cardiac and organ damage. So you mentioned the causative mechanisms. Mm-hmm. So description of diseased microbiomes is one thing, but identification of causative mechanisms, mm-hmm. and one way microbiota communicate with the host is by means of the metabolites, mm-hmm. which are resorbed, mm-hmm. and which have an impact on host inflammation and maybe blood pressure. Mm-hmm. So there are loads of metabolites to be discovered, mm-hmm. and short-chain fatty acids are one of them.
Right. We have found that to be the case in our model as well. And I shouldn't fail to mention Dr. Plusnik's group was one of the first ones that did allude to this point with their G-protein coupled receptor research. That short-chain fatty acids could indeed be modulators, and their receptors could be coming in from the host genome perspective. In our model, we have variants of many other G-protein-coupled receptors that are fantastic targets to look at, whether they are cross-talking. Again, even with doing all of this, I think we are very small in our mechanistic approach. Don't you agree?
I agree.
Yeah, there appears to be much more that we need to dwell into for renal influence of from the gut, and then signaling from the gut to various other organs that are implicated in blood pressure regulation, right? Overall, we are very excited to take this head on and move forward in this area of research, which one day, hopefully, there'll be a nice magic pill that we haven't thought about at this time. But this is could be the beginnings of going there with it in terms of targeted dietary bacterial load into hypertensives to be provided in addition to the DASH diet.
Wonderful. Thank you very much for the interview.
Thank you.
All the best for your presentation tomorrow.
To you too. Thank you very much.
Thank you.